asked this, but I forgot your answer. Who knows Freddy the Frog or already has Freddy the Frog? All right, so we got a few, like five. All right, so, which is fine. It's, again, if all of you had raised your hand, I would skip the introductory part because there's no point. But I'm going to buzz through, because when I teach about how to use Freddy and all of that, I can do an all-day workshop and do all these sequential lessons that can go after that and all of so forth. So this is going to be a very quick excerpt. So first of all, how many use a puppet in your room? How many use the same puppet for every music class? That is the magic tool that I discovered when I started this thing. The difference, what happens is the kids come to see Freddy, not me, right? And everything is Freddy's idea, including if I happen to hit the wrong song on my iPad, Freddy was messing around with the iPad. It's his mistake, and they giggle. If somebody in the back of the room is giggling and not doing their job, all you have to do with little kids especially is, Freddy, what are you doing? What? You want to play a game? And you've got them. They've forgotten about what they're wiggling about, and they're right here. So I don't truly, honestly care if it's Freddy. Any puppet would be the same effect. But there is a magic tool with pre-K, kindergarten, first and second grade, because he is not a puppet to them. He is real. And the reason that he is real is because I built a story around him and gave him a personality. Now, I did this in the beginning as a storyteller, and then the success rate of the retention of what the kids understood after the story, by learning through the story, was so high, that's when I developed the actual physical book with the CD so everybody could participate if they wanted to and use the same tool. So here's a little glimpse, the very first book, and if you've never used Freddy and you're thinking, hey, I want to give that a try, I highly recommend that you start with the first story. Here's why. Even if this is not the way you want to go about things, to kids, you have to remember this is just a story. So it introduces them to who he is, who his best friend is, and where he comes from. After that, you can jump to any story that is of your interest and go. But do the first one first and then jump as you want. So here's how it works. When it starts, and I'm not going to play the track today, they each come with an audio CD and they have animated voices. He has his own character voice. So the same way if I say Elmo, most all of you can hear Elmo's voice in your head. Kids are the same way. When they see Freddy, they hear his voice in their head because of the audio tracks on the CD, which you'll get to hear a snippet of one in a bit. So therefore, this is the way I use Freddy in the classroom, and I would love and highly recommend that everybody else does too. What? You want to tell the story? I'm sorry. I'm talking too much? Oh, so sorry. Okay. What you just did, kids get it. So notice what a great ventriloquist I am. Nah. And when I started, I basically stuck him on my head. I was just experimenting. I thought, I wonder if this would work. And I had no idea how to, I did not practice. I just stuck him on and I went, oh, he's alive! I mean, you know, it didn't matter. That's all I needed to do. And then as we came along, and they'd say, well, can Freddy write on the board? Can Freddy play the instrument? And so then, sure, Freddy can write on the board. And then you're like, yeah, he can. And they clap for Freddy and, you know, life is good. So, here is Freddy, and Freddy wants to tell a story. And this is Freddy, love to sing. He lives on Treble Clef Island in the Sea of Music. And this is a, up here in the trees is his house. And boys and girls, this is a map of Treble Clef Island. And this is called a staff. So it's a map that's called a staff of where he lives. And this marks a spot of where he lives. I think my battery just died. Nope, there it is. So that's where Freddy lives. And it, through the process, every story is interactive, so they thump, 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 and they hear this elephant. He doesn't know it's an elephant. He thinks it's a monster that's going to squish him. Come to find out, it's a kid elephant who's very bored, and they become best friends. Okay. From there on, He and Eli are best friends and do all their adventures together. Eli wants to teach him the hokey pokey, so that's put your trunk in, put your ears in, walk like an elephant kind of thing. Eli lives here, takes him to his home, and all kinds of things happen. Now they rock out and do bomb, 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 yeah, kind of deal. And then at the end of the story, you go, who lives here?
Freddy.
Who lives here?
Eli.
And if you have Freddy and you know, I had a couple of hands, so yell out if you know the answers.
Eli's vacation. No, Freddy's vacation house. Eli's vacation house. The crocodile river.
Excellent. And that's what the kids do. And there's the picture answers. Thank you for that. And then when they're in the first grade, you guys are so smart. I know you've been learning all about sounds and into kindergarten, whenever. What does Freddie start with? F. Okay, so now let's just say F instead. And then we take it in all kinds of extension activities, and all my extension activities are in beyond the books. So for the first books, beyond the books is the extension activities of how to sequence the learning after the story. But you have a couple of kids that would be up at the Glockenspiel. Freddie, I'm gonna put you down, okay. Bye. And we would have flashcards out. They would locate where Freddie's home is. And then, can you find, did you know? Oh, I'm missing gaps, sorry. One day he wants to play a game. We'll play this game really quickly. So, this is how I do it. He always wants to play a game. Which kids love. You want to play Name That Tune? Okay. All right, I've got it. All right, if you know what this is, raise your hand. Very good. Now I'm going to be rude to you, but of course you would say to the kids, can you sing that? Twinkle,
twinkle.
That's beautiful. Lovely. Okay, so now, boys and girls, wait a minute. We're not finished. But I thought, we just played the game. The game's not finished. Okay, all right. Oh, but Freddie, that's what I just sang. And they guessed it. They guessed Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, and they sang it beautifully. More than one song goes to that melody. Now, what did they just learn? Determine melody. I mean, you know, there's all kinds of concepts by using those real words. Okay, well, let's try it again. So we know, we already guessed Twinkle Twinkle. What else could it be? Bob Bob Black Sheep. You'd sing that. Oh, you're so good. Then we'd go through that again. There's another one. And did somebody else guess another? ABCs. All right, ding, ding. All right, now, would you sing the ABCs and watch Freddie? Ready?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Whoa, I'm sorry, he's screaming at, what? That's not right. That was the ABCs, right, kids? Yeah, you're kindergarten, all right. And, what? It's not your ABCs? What do you mean, not your ABCs? Really? On Treble Clef Island, they only have 7 letters in their ABCs. I don't know. Could we sing Freddie's alphabet? What would kindergarten say?
Yes.
Thank you. And what are those, boys and girls? A, B,
C, D, E, F, G.
That's it. And then we would sing A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And on one of the tracks on the CD that has the accompaniment, it has Freddie and Eli singing it so the kids can sing along. Now we have established that Freddie's ABCs are 7 letters. And another day, boys and girls, did you know that Freddie's alphabet is on every musical instrument in the world? In fact, you know those pianos? They have white and black notes. And on the white notes, there are invisible letters. They are Freddie's ABCs. Wow! Okay, you know, the kids are like, and so, did you see Freddie's ABCs on here? Yeah, there they are. Okay, now we have to find out which one is Freddie's home. Because notice that she said there was Freddie's home and Freddie's vacation home. And once you experience the story, you know, you get that. But so Freddy's home is that one up there. And I'm not sure this is, I can't even see it. There it is. That seems awfully high. But we'll go with that. All right, so that's the F. And then, so we would have one child with their glockenspiels or whatever pitched instruments you're using, and they're pretending to be Freddy on the F, and the other one's pretending to be Eli on the E, and they have a conversation, okay? So let's have a conversation as a group. So child A is Eli, or Eli child is gonna go, how are you? And the other one says, I am fine. Oh, what do you want to do? Pretend you're on the cell phone. What would you say, Eli? Do you want to come and play? Freddie says, yes, I do. And so you start to create a little story, but what they're doing is they're connecting that visual of the flashcard, which is over there on the rack, matches this pitch. Am I making sense? Mm-hmm. And that is also a great way to pull in creativity, composing, collaboration, all those things. They're getting the wheels turning in those higher order ways. So that's the setup for the first, for three of the books are note names. So this is the other six treble clef notes. Freddie and Eli are an adventure. These are peek through pages. This is six bass clef notes. Freddie has a scary dream and he wants to tell everybody about it. We talk about scary dreams and he wants to share his. And these are lift the flap pages. And then at the end you have that same type of review and you take it to the appropriate instruments. That is the teacher's book with extension lessons and some JPEG files that you can pull in if you have interactive whiteboards in your classroom. Which, by the way, how many of you do have interactive whiteboards? Either SmartBoard, Promethean, Mimeo, whatever else. Okay, so some of you. So there's JPEGs and files to pull into whichever program you use, and we have some other resources today. And take off on that, and downloadable coloring pages, and there's an assessment thing in there that I used. I have a website that I'm developing now, which should launch in 2 weeks. TeachingWithFreddyTheFrog.com has video clips of me doing things, and it has ideas, and it's a place, it's just now launching. Whoever's part of that can share ideas of what they do in the room. It doesn't have to be Freddy. It can be anything that works with kids. And then there's FreddyTheFrog.com, which is a free website that you can download coloring pages that go with the books, and games that review the concepts. And also we have a Freddy the Frog iPad app. There's a free version and there's a paid version. They are identical. The reason that we had the free version was so anybody that wanted to try it could try it for free and not have to go through the red tape of getting an iPad app on your school iPad. They're not free to make, unfortunately. So there are in-app purchases for the other levels, but there are games in there that you can do to get started. Other schools have iPad labs. Anybody here have that? Okay, so you know you have 25 iPads, everybody has one, and they probably have a school license. It's a volume educational discount. You can only use, what that means is that when you download an app, if you use the education volume discount, you can use one school license to pull down apps and put them on all those iPads. They only offer that with paid apps. So therefore, we had to do a paid version, which everything's unlocked. And if you have 10 or more downloaded at one time in the education volume discount, it's 50% off. So it's really affordable. And then, like $2 or something per app. And then, what was I gonna say? And the other way, if you do the free version, it's one license per app. If you get that, great, and if you don't, just ask me later and I'll explain. So anyway, that's why there's two versions on that. So here's kind of play the games. That's what the site looks like. These are some of the games, snapshots. You drag over letters, pop them in, and you beat the timer. These are matching games. You have to name the note in order to get the color with your finger on the app, and then you can save it. And